played a lot of GBA games growing up. I wasn't spending time on my GameCube back in 2002. I was playing on my Game Boy Advance, playing games like Metroid Zero Mission, Sonic Advance 2, and Mario Luigi Superstar Saga. But I dug through my junk drawer recently, and all I find are these. Ew.
I played these kinds of games, movie tie-ins, TV show games, and a bunch of bad ports. What was my family thinking? Now I wanted to replay these to see, are these games as bad as I remember, or is my childhood self dumb? The answer is yes. Most of them are bad. Alright, first up is one I did remember enjoying as a kid, Jimmy Boy Genius Jet Fusion, developed by THQ. While I never played the clunky console version, the game is just a lot of fun for me as far as I can remember. The story revolves around Jimmy using this virtual world reproduction machine to review a book for his book report. However, the machine malfunctioned and Jimmy and his friends are sucked into the book. Now Jimmy along with Jet Fusion must rescue his friends and defeat the one behind it, Professor Calamitous. Jet Fusion is still a fun game in my eyes. It's a 2D platformer slash action game. Jimmy is armed with a sonic resonator which shoves waves at enemies and can even be upgraded to do more damage and even bounce off walls. He can also use these throwable bombs called micro dischargers to kill any enemy that comes into contact, and a few more upgrades along the way, like a gumball machine to make platforms, a helicopter for Goddard, and even a submarine too. While I enjoyed playing the first level for this video, a few things irked me. For one, I feel like Jimmy's jump is too floaty. He jumps like he's on the moon at times. Secondly, anime AI is as dumb as bricks, seeing as most of them just run forward. I mean, look at this guy. However, I think people, whether they're fans of the show or not, can enjoy this. It's got really fluent controls, nice gameplay, and a surprisingly good soundtrack for GBA standards. Alright, on to the next game, Power Rangers SPD. This one was a Christmas gift from my younger brother, and seeing as he loved this incarnation of the Power Rangers, needless to say, I didn't play this until he moved on to other shows. Believe it or not, this one was developed by Natsume, the same company that made the Harvest Moon games as well as previous Power Ranger games with the SNES. I won't explain the plot thing because I never watched SPD, but long story short, bad guys invade Earth. Good, good. So Power Rangers SPD is a 2D beat-em-up, and holy crap, this game is fun too! You play as the different color rangers, and each have unique qualities. Blue ranger can double jump, red ranger can do a wall kick, and yellow and pink ranger can dodge roll. What does green ranger do? I don't know. He's boring. Each of them even have unique special techniques. Blue ranger can put up a shield to block bullets, red ranger can walk through solid objects, yellow ranger can duplicate herself, and pink ranger can punch through metal doors. What does green ranger do? I don't know. He's boring. There's even different minigames first in, like a Space Invader style game, racing levels, and Megazord battles. And this soundtrack is really good. Ray Ranger stages especially. I'd say give this one a try because this is actually a really decent game. Nothing grand, but still pretty decent. Alright, next. Alright, this one isn't really a TV tie-in like the previous ones, but still a game from childhood. Sean Palmer's Snowboarder. I remember always putting this game down into the first level. Why?
Just the controls are way too loose.
I can't turn worth shit, I jump way too high, landing on rails is clunky, tricks are done by mashing the A button, this game just sucks. Next.
Oh. No.
Cars. I fucking hate this movie, so I don't even know why I got this. But I'm optimistic. Maybe it's decent.
Oh god, I'm still sliding around worse than Yuri Katsuki's skating career!
What the fuck happened to quality control in a driving game? Lightning controls like he's on ice, making sharp turns is a fucking bitch to do. How do they expect me to drive like this when you do turns like this? Can you feel the sunshine? Does it brighten up the day? Don't you feel the
sunshine? You just need to run away. Alright, final game. Open season. I don't remember enjoying this game nor the movie, so I have low expectations. Oh? Okay, this is a surprise. This is actually pretty good. Boo controls really smoothly, combat's fine, level design is good, graphics are nice. I'm impressed. I thought I'd hate this, but this is a decent movie tie-in.
You know, playing these again kind of surprised me. I really enjoyed most of these. I mean, sure, they're not grand or epic, but they were still a good time. I definitely would recommend a couple of them. But I can't end it there. It's too generous. I got it.